The Minister of State for Kampala Affairs, Kabuye Chofa Togabye, decried the persistent budget cuts for KCCA over the last three financial years, which he says has critically suffocated the operations and activities of the authority. The KCCA budget for 2022-2023 has been cut by 208 billion shillings compared to the current financial year.
As we proceed, my first request is to seek the indulgence of you, Honorable Chair, and the committee to reinstate our priorities totaling 150 billion so that we can at least go back to 566 billion, which will enable us move the city, though not enough, but at least we can start from there.
Again, we have cried to this out to this government that Kampala is the main stakeholders when it comes to the issues of contributing to the economy of this country. Kampala contributes a lot to the coffers of this country. But again, when you look at the budget it gets from central government, again, it is little. I remember KCCA previously had requested for a consideration of the 3% of the national budget to make sure that at least the roads and the drainage systems, together with the issues of solid waste, are being sorted. But even up to now, government has not seen that as a priority. That is why every financial year for the last 6 years, we are experiencing budget cuts.
Affected activities include drainage, road maintenance, among others. Chofa Togabye appealed to the Committee for the Presidential Affairs to push the Ministry of Finance to enhance the KCCA budget with 150 billion shillings to mitigate the budget shortfalls on top of 419 billion shillings that has been allocated.
We needed the 150 billion, which was cut, to be reinstated. Then we can move on and we plan better for the next financial year.
The first problem that you will have to notice is that roads in Kampala are not proper, in the sense that Kampala was planned some years ago, and the plan was in the sense that it never accommodated such a population. Now that the population has grown too huge, and we still continue using those same roads which were planned before, it has brought a lot of jam.
We have advocated on several committees and requested the government to increase the budget of Kampala, that even the one that is given presently today is not enough to enable the city look good or to be a standard city.
KCCA is seeking for additional 17 billion shillings to facilitate the remuneration of KCCA political leaders. Chofa Togabye told the committee that out of the required 17 billion shillings, 10.2 billion shillings will be spent on councillors' salaries, while 6.7 billion shillings will be spent on other associated costs of allowances, furniture and other things. The number of councillors has risen from 258 to 464 following the implementation of new electoral reforms.
The question was, what brought the problem was the increment in the number. Councillors more than doubled. They were 268, now they, 58, now they became 468. So it was a budgetary problem. They over doubled. So the funds we had could only last them for 6 months or 7 months.
Salaries for Speaker and Deputy Speaker for KCCA and Urban Division Councils have still not been allocated due to lack of a legal framework that spells out their salaries and allowances. The KCCA Amendment Act of 2015, which led to the establishment of the positions of Speaker and Deputy Speaker at City Hall, is silent on the facilitation and emoluments of these leaders. The chairperson of the Committee on Presidential Affairs, Jessica Ababiko, blamed the minister for reluctantly failing to table the amendment before parliament for consideration.
We blame the political heads of Kampala and the metropolitan areas, because the omission is a small omission. The provision that is supposed to empower the minister to ensure the facilitation of the speakers and the deputy speakers is missing in the act. And we resolved that this needs to come to the House so that we correct this and enable the minister to do his or her work.
Honorable Abubakar Kawalya, the Noop Rubaga North MP, thinks there is political foul play to sideline the welfare of KCCA speakers and their deputies.
But the challenge, where the challenge comes, when it came to the interpretation of the law by the Solicitor General, they disregarded the payment of the speakers and they instead paid the executive secretaries. So to me, this game looked to be intentional. And now Parliament recently guided that we should have an amendment of the law where the minister will determine the movements of the offices of the lead of the speakers for Kampala.
KCCA also seeks 60 billion shillings, which remains a major unfunded priority over a five-year period, effective financial year 2022-2023, in order to implement the Kampala Integrated Waste Management Program. According to the KCCA Ministerial Policy Statement for the financial year 2022-2023, the funds are required to decommission Chitezi Landfill and operationalize the new landfill at Dundu in Mukono to improve waste collection and disposal in the city. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.